Another religious leader is at the center of a political controversy today. The Dalai Lama cannot visit his own country, Tibet, but today he was welcomed in Taiwan. As ABC's Jim Laurie reports, the people there may be glad he's visiting, but the government of mainland China is not.
His welcome in Taiwan was the kind that Tibet's holiest leader could only dream of in mainland China. The Dalai Lama had come here, he said, as a first step toward a return to the mainland and Tibet from where he was forced to flee 38 years ago. He told ABC News, no matter what China's communists say, Tibetan Buddhism is no threat to them.
They create impression that we Tibetans are anti-Chinese. That's not the case. And we are not against China, we are not against Chinese people, we are not against Chinese culture.
While he says this is a religious visit, by coming to Taiwan, the Dalai Lama steps into a political minefield. Beijing is outraged. This visit brings together two popular leaders the Chinese communists continually demonize, Taiwan's President Li Donghui and the Dalai Lama, men who Beijing accuses of splitting China by advocating independence for their regions. Charges the Dalai Lama says are not true.
You want independence for Tibet?
No. No.
What he wants, he says, is enough self-rule to stop the destruction of Tibetan culture. Under repressive policies, hundreds of the Dalai Lama's followers have been imprisoned. China has encouraged ethnic Chinese to settle in Tibet, trying to make it just a part of China. In Lhasa, the capital, less than half the population is now Tibetan.
Therefore, you see, Buddhist culture, I feel, at the moment, facing danger of extinction.
And so he has come here. The visit may not solve the conflict between China and Tibet, but it will draw attention to Tibet's plight. Jim Laurie, ABC News, Kaohsiung, Taiwan.